All right, so we are live now. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to yet another episode of That's Life. Today, I'm very proud to have with me my friend from college, Dr. Rakesh Suri. Rakesh Suri is a personality which we'll get to know through the course of this conversation, but he's a person I actually look up to, and he's somebody that you know, everybody could learn a thing or two from. So welcome, buddy Suri. Welcome to That's Life. It's so great to have you here. And should we start?
Thanks, Atul, for first of all having me here in your program and hearing such words from a batchmate are just awesome.
Thank you. So, Suri, I always start the show from school, you know, right from where our journey began.
Okay.
So, would you like to tell our viewers a little bit about your schooling, where it was, and what all you did and learned?
It is very interesting in my life that I did not study in first, second, and third class.
Wow.
First class which I attended was fourth standard, and that too in a Srinagar, in a Kendriya Vidyalaya.
Hmm.
And that is the only first photograph I have. I have no certificates from that time because of the quick shifting out from Srinagar because of various reasons. And
okay.
So I loved the Kendriya Vidyalaya from fourth till 10th class. 10th standard. It was an awesome time. We are friends even now. WhatsApp has brought people, you know, together.
Yes,
so we are our fourth standard are friends now on WhatsApp.
Wow. Yeah, we have our KG friends. Ashok is one of them.
Oh.
So that's good. That's great. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
So Suri, what you did your 10th from Srinagar?
And then came to Jammu Tavi to do PUC. See, we were the last batch for 10 plus 2 10th.
I did PUC as well. I went to Chennai to do my PUC.
I was warned by my seniors that 10 plus 2 is a new thing. And if you do plus 2, you may not be able to score well because it's a new thing. So you better go to standard state PUC because you score well and you get a good admission. And that's what. That's the first good advice, great advice I got. And I got Bits Pilani because of that.
Same here. I went to Chennai, Madras Christian College, and I got Bits Pilani because of that.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Wonderful. Yeah. So what was it about school and in school that, you know, made you the person you are? You know, because the foundations are laid during our school days. So would you like to share some learnings which you could remember, some teachers, some anecdotes?
See, in school, luckily, I was a good student, studies-wise. Not extracurricular-wise, I was not that good a student.
Okay.
And I had great friend circle there. And I was very pally with most of my teachers.
Okay.
So I had a fantastic time in school. And they all, my teachers used to, you know, give my example to all, so I used to feel very nice. And I remember in winters, we used to sit under a tent. And if the tent roof will be having snow and we'll be sitting inside with something called Bukhari.
I know.
Right? Okay. That so it has a pipe, I mean, it has a pipe for going out of the tent outside through a hole. And I remember that most of us will put some water pot on that to boil. And we'll have hot water. So we used to love you know, playing with snow, and near our school there was a huge garden which had almond trees. And we were strictly warned all the time not to venture there and, you know, take out almonds from the tree. So all these are very nice memories we have.
And those were those green almonds.
Yes, green almonds. Yeah, and the flowers are very beautiful of almond tree.
I know.
So that's what I remember about school.
And tell me, Suri, you said you were not too much into extracurricular activities. So there in Srinagar, probably you had a lack of playing grounds, etc. also, and a lot of snow, etc.
No.
Or were there snow games or such
No,
thing.
school had the usual games,
They
which
had the grounds.
most
Okay.
schools have.
Cricket, football, everything was there.
Everything, and what I was very average. What used to interest me in school was reading books. And we, I think, set up the first book club in Kendriya Vidyalaya in fourth standard.
Wow.
And there are six teachers who became members of that. And it was
Excellent.
important to bring them into that club because they used to fund our books.
Ah.
I'm talking about story books, huh? Or we used to call pocket books.
Pocket books, yes.
Yeah, so we used to buy.
So if can you remember some titles?
No, I don't. Enid Blyton was our favorite.
Of course, I have gone through the whole
We
thing.
read each and every Enid Blyton book. Then we shifted to various those levels, you know, this green, red, blue level. I don't remember those levels also now.
Yes.
And our teachers used to also read. And so they used to give
Wonderful.
money for buying books, which we would share between teachers and students. So that I remember a lot. And I think I formed a small library at home. And I decided that I will be, you know, to friends who want those books from me should pay fees so that I can buy more books.
Great.
It didn't work because people, my friends, took the books and didn't give me money, and books also never came back.
And books never come back. Yes, that's what happened.
So, but
Books and
that was
information
a
goes away.
very nice time. I'm a very fond of reading. Even today, I read at least one or two books a week. So that I love. That I
So,
love from childhood.
which is the latest book that you are reading or read?
Right now I'm reading, I'm very fond of reading modern physics papers which get published. So right now I'm reading about quantum mechanics, and it's a very esoteric topic. Right now it's talking about multi-universes. I'm reading about that.
Great. Wonderful. That's so interesting. So Rakesh, from Jammu Tawi, you transited to BITS Pilani.
Yeah.
Now tell me about your journey in BITS. And was it at BITS that you found your love
Yeah.
and life partner,
Absolutely,
Dr.
absolutely.
Alka Suri, another great
Yes.
person, another great scientist?
Yeah.
So I'll be having Alka on the show.
Yeah.
I'll be inviting her to the show. So yes, Rakesh, tell us about your journey in BITS.
BITS, when we entered, it was like, you know, as if somebody has put us into an ocean from a pond. Our exposure was, you know, too much. I didn't know English that time. I couldn't speak English, so I used to feel very shy speaking to seniors and my compatriots who came from South who didn't know how to speak Hindi. So initial that hiccup to speak
And you
English.
were good with Hindi, Punjabi, and all that. You were very good,
Yeah. Yeah,
but
they were
English
not
was a
able to
challenge.
understand. So slowly I started learning English and they started learning Hindi.
Wow.
So, and mixing was not a big challenge, but we were shocked when the first semester result came that we couldn't score well. We said we are one of the best students from J&K State and never able to score well. What is this? Then somebody told me, "Boss, all these students who have come are all toppers of their states. You're
Correct.
competing in a
Everybody's a topper.
different, you're competing in a different level."
Level.
So that was a good learning there. And then of course I met Alka, as you mentioned there, and
And
got
Alka joined
my
in 1979, a year after
year after. She's
us.
1 year junior to me.
Yeah.
And then
So what did you do during the first year?
first year I tried to study, but I couldn't do much. And
Okay.
then I met Alka.
All right.
So then studies
Then
took,
also you couldn't do much.
I couldn't do much.
But you did much.
We passed out in time. That itself was a great achievement.
Yes.
And with okay grades to get a job and start our careers, basically.
So at BITS, what are the activities that you took part in, and how do you think the atmosphere there, creates
At
individuals like
BITS,
you?
I had the same thing that I was not very interested in studies. But I used to love reading books there too. And I also used to do very weird kind of experiments there. I first decided that I want to make a, you know, we used to have cassette, song cassettes, with 60 minutes. I said,
Yeah,
why
the
can't
ones
we
that
not?
you rolled with the pen or
Yeah,
pencil.
pencil. So I said, why can't we make a 120 minute cassette using the same material? I worked on it for 4 months. I failed. But this project became famous amongst my group, even amongst professors, that what I was trying. Then after this failure, I said that there is a method we can know the taste of potassium cyanide without tasting it.
Wow.
So I started working on linking the taste to pH value of the chemical. I worked on it for 2-3 months. And I think I was quite close to the solution when I had to leave for, I think there was a strike. And we all left the campus. And when I came back, I was not given the key of the lab, which I was using for that work, you know. So I just left that. So I used to experiment and do things which were not, let's say, normal. And I loved doing them. And reading, as I said, has always been a great hobby. And we read a lot there. We had a huge, fantastic library. And we must have read a huge number of books.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Our friend Shevdeji is also here. He just said hi a couple of minutes ago.
Hi.
Shevdeji is here. Welcome, Shevdeji. So, Suri, tell us now, after BITS, you passed with electronics engineering, electronics and computer science.
Triple E.
Electrical and electronics engineering. Yeah. And then from there on, you went
to IT industry. I started with Bajaj Electricals.
Arun Bhargav, hi.
Hi, Arun. And I didn't enjoy Bajaj Electricals because I found that the environment there was very British kind, very stilted, very tough. You were supposed to stand up, you know, when seniors come. And, you know, people come from BITS Pilani, standing up and saying good morning, someone was not done.
Was this in Delhi? Bajaj Electricals?
No, I was taken to Bajaj Mumbai because what they did that year, the year they took us, they hired around 25 people from IITs and BITS Pilani. To create a replica of Tata Institute of Service. They wanted to replicate Bajaj.
Yeah, task-like hiring.
They wanted to do that. And we were the first batch. And our first year was fantastic because they really exposed us to all departments, all over India, travel, and they put us through a course in Bajaj College. After 1 year, they posted us to different branches. When that happened and I entered into the branch and I found this environment, which was very different kind. It was different kind. I didn't expect it from corporate. And I felt that it's not a place for me. And I left without a job in hand. Actually, I'm like that. If I don't like anything, I will give it some time. But I will not wait for an opportunity to come to leave that. I just
wait for something to happen. You'll make something happen.
I don't know, but people call me mad in that regard. But I left that job and came to Delhi without a job in hand. And I entered the IT industry that time, which was just taking off. And that's how I joined the company called PCL, Pertek Computers Limited. Dadan Bhai. Yeah, fantastic people. And what a learning we had. It was just fantastic time. And I worked in different IT companies throughout. And then last company I worked was DCM Technologies, Data Products. We had merged these two companies and I was their CEO and CEO for 6 years.
Global operations.
Japan, US, all reporting, 6 to 7 years. And then I left again. As I got tired of working in a corporate and answering only one thing every quarter. How to maximize the stakeholder value. I said, do I want to do this the whole life now? I spent 6 years answering every quarter how to increase shareholder value, stakeholder value. And I discussed with my family. I said, I want to do something that this is not, not something meant more for me now. And I decided to complete my PhD.
Okay.
And I was doing PhD along with my job. But as you know, it's very tough to do PhD along with the job.
Yes.
And I said, first I will finish my PhD, then I will decide what I want to do. And I took one year and finished my PhD from ABU in strategic management. And while I was doing that, I got approached by a VC who asked me to, start a company, start business. It sounds very interesting when someone tells you to start
again,
business.
Again, in the IT area?
IT area only, IT area. He was from US and
based in Delhi.
He is US based.
No, the company will be based in Delhi.
India, US, global companies nowadays, those time also. So he told me that you know, when you set up your own company, then you know, sky is the limit. You might as well be flying in jets and all that. So although money was not the main factor which took me to business, you'll be surprised what was the main motivation factor for me to enter business. I wanted to earn enough money to start an NGO.
Beautiful.
I was under the wrong impression that you need personal money only to start a good and big NGO.
Wow.
I was working at that time when I was CEO of DCM. I was working with a NGO called Scale. My ex-boss, MD of Acer, Arun Sinha, had started this NGO and he had forcibly recruited me to help him in this NGO. And I learned a lot in that NGO.
What were you doing in that NGO?
Scale was working in a place called Bhimtal in Uttarakhand.
Bhimtal. Okay, I've been to
Bhimtal. Yeah. So we in Scale were learning to provide computer literacy program to local population. We set up a computer lab there. Then in the same room, we also set up a, you know, sewing machine unit for ladies for making clothes and all. We did a lot of experiments there. And luckily I was part of those experiments and decision making. My learning was immense. We knew what works, what doesn't work, what can be scaled, what cannot be scaled. And then I decided that if I'm going to enter business now, I must have enough money to start a larger version of Scale. And
if I may ask, sorry to interrupt, where is Scale now? What are they doing now?
Scale is our partner at Computer Shiksha.
Okay.
Scale is handling our foray into Uttarakhand. And we have implemented our Computer Shiksha solution with help of Scale in 126 schools in Uttarakhand.
Excellent.
And 126 schools, you can imagine that will be around, even if you take 100 minimum number of students, it will be 126 schools into 100 students. Means around 12,000 to 15,000 students are studying.
Beautiful. Excellent.
The Scale is our partner.
Great. Yeah. Go on.
So this, my dialogue with the VC was that my purpose is to earn money to start NGO because I feel now it has already spent 1.5 years without salary. We think that we may survive for some longer time because Alka is earning. She's a government professional. He had shown us fantastic future that sky is the limit. Now, what happened was very interesting. Actually, reverse happened. The year was 2008. We had spent literally $1 million with me guaranteeing 50% of that fund. And within 14 months after we had finished spending $1 million, you know what happened in 2008?
Yes, crash. The
bubble burst.
A great market crash, yes.
And I was left holding 50% of $1 million spent as a debt.
Yeah.
So that was a... Now imagine my intention was to start an NGO with the money. I was holding a debt of $500,000.
Yeah, now you're already in minus $500,000.
Huge. So he and I talked, VC and I talked that what should we do? I told him, look, we have a house in Gurgaon. I can sell that and give you money and then we have Square and I can start my job back. And I'll come back to that because my goal is very clear. I want to start an NGO. And I think that initially I need my money to start. He says, why do we give up? Let's do one thing. You keep running the company. I will fund it. You don't participate in the losses anymore.
Wow.
So I asked him, are you sure? he agreed. It took us 6-7 years, literally 2 years back only, we have paid off that $1 million. But debt I entered in doing this, that still remains, but a small portion, which is manageable portion. We'll square off that. So, and we are still partners. We also have launched a wellness portal, India's first wellness portal.
I'll talk to you about that later in the show.
It became live on 1st December in India.
Wow.
And Swapanlekha, ma'am, who's our co-founder of Computer Shiksha, is handling that
vertical.
Yeah. Interesting thing was that come to Computer Shiksha to link how it happened?
Yes.
Please. Now that we learned that entering business is not the surefire way to earn money to start an NGO, with some colleagues and I, we said, let's not wait for money. Let's start. We have 5-6 of us from...
You're all colleagues from previous enterprise?
Oh, no, we were, see, mixed. Some professionals from IT industry were ex-colleagues. Then Swapanlekha, who and I used to meet when we were visiting professor
Okay.
to various
Okay.
institutes, and we
Wow.
talked what we should do. So we said, let's start an NGO without waiting for money and without waiting for that large chunk of money. And
Now, can I say that this seed was born in your mind during your scale days? Okay.
yes,
And the
absolutely.
scale experience became a foundation
Yes.
for your success in computer Shiksha.
I think if I wouldn't have been part of scale, I couldn't have scaled the competition the way I could scale.
Agreed. Understood. Perfect.
Yeah. So when we started discussing as what to do, we decided that let's do first research as what is required by society and where our skills can be, optimally utilized and best utilized. We
This
hired
was
an.
which year? Which year was this?
This was in 2012 beginning,
Okay, 2012.
January,
Perfect. January.
and we hired an MBA intern. We are habitual of doing research before we do take any decision, and we told this MBA person that you go to 50, 60 schools near my home, and we want this kind of a report. So we gave him the report format. He came back after that full 60 schools he covered. And the data showed that all these schools, whichever he visited, whatever level of schools they may be, they were able to do a good, better, or best job of English, Hindi, maths, and their curriculum. But none of them was able to do anything about computer literacy
Wow.
at all. So we wanted to know why so. So we spent time on that also, and we came to following conclusions. One is that computers are expensive. Schools
Okay.
can't buy them easily. And even if somebody donates to them, they're not easy to maintain. Some virus will come, they will not know what to do. And there are not many people available in the ecosystem to repair those systems. And that too, they would like free of cost repair. So maintenance is a big problem. Third was what to teach. If you look at all the books in India today in computer literacy, they are theoretical in nature. So there is no link between your computer learning and those books. So that also is a problem. Fourth problem, the biggest problem we found to be the biggest ultimately was who will teach? Anyone
Must
who
have
knows
this
even a bit of MS Office would like to work in a corporate job and
corporate
not in a school or not even an NGO. So these were the big hindrances.
challenges.
We didn't have an answer to any at that time, but we said, let's take some fundamental decisions. We will not form an organization right now. Let four, five of us start implementing it in the field, learn, and then decide what to do. So first question to be answered was what to teach. And after we saw Microsoft DLC, we saw all programs in the world, and we found that none of them are suitable for children.
Beautiful.
So we also wanted to be clear that we want to teach right from nursery to MCom. They all should be able to study our course. So
Now
the
that
question
was your aim initially.
was, from day one,
Now you are catering to
all levels.
all levels.
Yes, all levels. We are catering to
Okay.
professionals. We are catering to professionals in corporate also today.
All right.
So
Okay. So this
one.
number which you have, this number includes
No,
people
no, no.
across,
No, this number
this
is
is
only
schools.
children, schools.
This is only schools. Which classes?
I'll come to that
Yeah,
because
okay.
these are all
Sure.
interesting things which we discovered ourselves. So, course, then we said that let's go back to basics and we will teach the children MS Paint, MS Office, full suite, Word, Excel, PPT, internet, and email. And he said that if any child, any student, be it nursery or MCom, if he or she knows these softwares or these, skills, he or she will get a job properly. Not a computer job, but any job in the world will
Yes, would
require
require
computer literacy.
this.
Yeah. So we were very clear that we are not imparting a skill. Computer literacy has become like Hindi, English, math, a necessity to enter a marketplace for a job. And it's not that if you know MS Paint or MS Office, you get a job. That's not number two, because data entry and all is gone. It's all shifted to AI. And human beings are not required to do low-end data entry. You know?
True.
So with this realization, we started designing the course. So what did we did? We tied up with a school near my home. It was being run in a cow shed. And we bought 15 laptops. We created a course for 4 days only. And
so
we decided
these 15 laptops were with your own money. You all pulled in and...
Pulled in. We begged. We told everybody, please donate a laptop. You know? So we bought 15 laptops, one projector. I gave my Marquee 800 for this and screen, and we tied up with a school nearby. And we told...
2 day curriculum.
2 days curriculum, Saturday, Sunday. Because we were working people. We said, we will teach ourselves, no employee initially. We designed the course for 2-3 weeks and said, we'll continue developing as we continue teaching.
As you go along.
As you go along. So we started teaching in this school, Saturday, Sunday. I was the admin in charge. My job used to be 7:30 reach the school. Set up
the laptops,
projector, everything. Set up the class and wait for others to come in. Children will come in, then the classes will start. Then at the end, it was my job to dismantle everything, put in the car and bring it home. And we had one lady who actually designed our course. She is one of the best corporate trainers in India. And she designed for these children also.
And she's still with you?
Unfortunately, she's having some medical condition and she's not with us.
All right. But her work is there.
Oh, so. Yeah, we are there because she was there.
Yeah, there's no sense. I understand.
So interesting thing happened was, in this school, we were doing 1 hour class. So 15 laptops means 15 children, 1 hour. We were doing 4 hours classes only. So 15 into 4, 60 children were studying. Within 1 month of this class, next Saturday when we go, the owner of the school, he's a great man, Khurana sir.
And Khurana ji, I've met.
I know.
I've met. You took me. Yeah. You took me to Khurana ji.
This school operates under tents.
Yes, I know. I keep talking to him sometimes.
On the road.
Yes, and, yes, I remember.
Mr. Khan told me, you need to do something. I said, what happened? He says, we have a strike in our school.
Everybody wants it.
They're asking, why these 60 children only? Why not us?
Yes.
So this was a very difficult question to answer, but we came to easy answer that time, that let's increase the number of hours to 4 to 6, and let's increase 15 laptops to 35 laptops. So 35 laptops into 6.
Cover more children.
200 children approximately. So he was happy, children were happy, we were happy. So it covered basically top 2 to 3 levels of class, like the senior most classes, not all in school. And they were satisfied. We taught like this for some time, and a lot of schools nearby started hearing about an experiment going on in the school on Saturday, Sunday. And they came to visit, and they asked us, why not our school? And we then started thinking that time may have come that we step back as implementers and we form a proper organization. And we do it Monday, Tuesday, one school, Wednesday, Thursday, second school, Friday, Saturday, third school. So that way we'll be able to deliver to 600 children. So we, that time, had around 50, 60 schools waiting list. So we picked the top 3 schools and started teaching 600 schools within 4 months of our operation. So we hired manpower, 2 trainers, 1 admin person.
And these trainers were full-time?
Oh, full-time. We took full-time manpower. We hired from BCA, you know, BCA, who were doing...
Yeah, BCA, I know.
They were doing BCA through part-time. So we picked them up and we told them that we will fund their education. We also give you salary, but you must give your heart out for these children. You'll be surprised that those people who we hired in May 2012 are still with us. And they become senior managers.
It's a career that they got.
Yeah, they have got. They didn't know that. We also didn't know that time. Wow. And now our list of schools which was waiting was increasing. And we were able to... Our capacity was limited to 600 children only.
And this is around Gurgaon.
Gurgaon, in Gurgaon, near our home.
Yeah, near your home, Sushant Lok area, and that
area.
This is around Gurgaon.
Yeah, huge number of schools.
And this is still the year 2012.
Year has not crossed yet. 2012.
Still 2012.
Yeah, we have reached 600, and it was, I think, 9th month that we said that let's double it.
Hmm.
Let's hire one more team, 2 trainers, 1 admin person, 1 car, 35 laptops. And, you know, we when calculated, we found we required 8 lakh rupees for doing all this, for starting basically. Schools were waiting list anyway, so that's not a problem.
Hmm.
Now we said, therefore, we till today we have, you know, funded from pocket. But 8 lakhs is a big amount, and I was had stopped working, and Swapan Lekha was also not working. We were, you know, focusing more.
You were visiting colleges and doing lectures and all
our
that stuff.
Hobby was becoming bigger than our careers and businesses at that time. Hmm. We said, let's do one thing. We have never asked money from people. Let's ask someone, okay, please give 8 lakhs, we'll double our capacity. Let's see what happens.
Hmm.
And an amazing thing happened. We had never asked for donation. So Swapan Lekha met someone in Mumbai. He had shifted to Mumbai that time, and in a party, and was telling that lady our experience of delivering computer literacy to 600 children, and how we want to increase it to 1200, double, we need 8 lakhs, and we don't have 8 lakhs. And remember, this is only 4 days after we have discussed that we need 8 lakhs.
Hmm.
And she was, oh, 8 lakhs is a small amount. You meet me tomorrow. I'll introduce someone. We never believed it because it doesn't happen like that.
Hmm.
But Swapan Lekha and I, we come from corporate world. We say all opportunities must be tested.
Explored, yes.
Explored. So she went and met that lady. They walked into a place, she introduced her, Swapan Lekha, and that guy said, okay, my CA is sitting outside. Go to meet him. And then he handed over a black check to Swapan Lekha. It was not 1 week which had passed. We said, look, the universe is telling us, please do your work. Money will arrange.
Absolutely.
So, 11th month of our operation, we were delivering computer literacy program to 1,200 children in 6 schools now. We felt that it's good, but you know, coming from corporate, we always have a habit of looking at our work and finding what flaws are there and how to improve it. Like, you know, we found that the cost efficiency is not being met.
Hmm.
It's very expensive. The each time you want to add 600 children, you need to spend 8 lakhs. Then you have to have running expenses for manpower, petrol, and all that.
Hmm.
So we didn't find it cost-wise efficient.
And Suri, just one diversion. What kind of salaries were you paying these chaps? Were you paying them what they would get in the market?
They would have got nothing in market because they were just students of BCA.
So you... It was like a paid internship kind of
thing. We have to pay internship. Hmm. And we were paying very low, and they were happy, and we were also happy.
Fine.
And now we said, let's go back to, you know, drawing board and
think seriously.
As how do we want to take this computer shiksha? And computer shiksha name, we didn't give. It was given by student. We were just talking, what should we name this NGO? One student walked in and said, "Are you doing computer shiksha? Name it computer shiksha."
Oh my God.
Computer shiksha.
It's a beautiful name.
Beautiful name, yeah. So, Sandeep Rana is a student, common student to Swapan Lekha and I. We taught him an MBA. And he named our NGO. He's our treasurer today. He's our treasurer, youngest person in our, you know, group. NGO. Yeah. So, when we went to drawing board, we said, let's go, let's do a proper study now.
Hmm.
We took NSSO 2014 data.
Hmm. Hmm.
And when we looked at it, we were shocked.
Hmm.
And NSSO 2014 data, if you analyze, you find that in India has 33 crore children between age 5 to 18, which is from class 1 to 12.
Hmm.
Should be. But out of this, 10 crore were not going to schools.
Hmm.
And we found that out of all the 33 crore, even if some were going to NGO schools, 24 to 25 crores were not getting any computer literacy. And not only that, we'll never get computer literacy because nobody, no state government, no central government has any plan in place to do that. Yeah. So all these children will pass out of their schools, colleges, without knowing anything about computers. And that would be catastrophic. Once they enter, they're not getting job.
Hmm.
So this number really, literally, you know, shook us.
Jolted you.
Then we found that if these children were to be taught, we will need 1.43 million teachers.
Hmm.
Knowing computers and delivering computer literacy. Look at the numbers. And then computer costs, maintenance costs. So if we are not able to solve all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements properly, this is a no-go. We might do 1,200 children, maybe 2,400, maybe 5,000 children, but that's right. It.
But otherwise, we cannot
can't make
scale
a
up.
Significant
can't make a significant gain. Contribution.
Gain.
Yeah.
So what do we do? We discussed this for a very long time, 1 month, I think. We kept discussing this, that what a solution. We said, let's solve the first thing first, which is teachers. One of us, he was joking that time, but that became serious topic of discussion. He said suddenly, why can't we develop computer course videos which do not require a human being? So you're saying human being means? He says, no human. See, all course videos are always made as an aid to teaching.
Yes.
They are never made as a replacement of human being.
Absolutely.
He said, but we have never seen and heard about a video which can replace a human teacher. You know, that's what I'm saying. We should develop that. It appeared as a joke at that time. But we started thinking very, very seriously about it. You'd be surprised, we did testing. We brought two of our best trainers back from the field and said, you sit in the office. And imagine a class is sitting in front of you. We started experimenting whether this work can be done or not. We said, look at this class as if they're children sitting in front of you and start speaking. How you address them? And whatever you're speaking, the second person should note down each and every word being spoken. So you record and then note down. So this is like a script. We developed the script for 2-3 days to test. Once script was developed for what speaking happens, we said in those 2-3 days, so these children, these trainers were teaching for a long time, our children, 2 years had passed. We said we will not grow until we solve the scalability issues. So till 2016, we never grew beyond 1,200 children until we solved the challenges. So these two trainers then wrote down script for 3 days, I remember. And we told them, what you do is, in these 3 days, whatever questions a student can ask, please use that. So they wrote down those questions also. We said, now you answer these questions in that script. As if somebody has asked this question, or even if they haven't asked, you should still want to explain. We did that. We did a very powerful script for 3 days. We said, now that you have this script ready, create a PPT matching this script. That also was done 3 days later. Then we said, now what you do is do a voiceover of merge this PPT and do a voiceover using the script. We did that also. So our imagined visualization was that video should be totally replace a human being. It should explain the way a human teacher does in a class. It should, since it cannot be interactive, so anticipate all the possible questions, because we had already spent 3 years time there in the field.
Answer them.
And we had all questions. And answer that in the video without them asking. When we were doing all this experimentation, we came to a realization that it's possible. It can be done.
Yeah, but that was the time, I think, one day you had called me over for lunch.
Yeah.
We had lunch there, this is what was going on in the office. And so, we were exploring the possibility of doing English along with this.
Absolutely.
Yes.
So when we decided that, we did around 4 or 5 months of experiments. And I was remembering my cassette experiment, which had failed. I was remembering my potassium cyanide experiment, which had failed. I said, this better not fail. This experiment better not fail. And we delivered, first 2-3 days of work, we felt might be able to solve the problem. We felt that. But the problem was, now we require professionals to develop these videos. So we said, one is professionals, one is that we can have the same manpower, train them on all software required to produce these videos, because they're the best people, they have taught these children. But still,
and they'll do it from the heart.
Heart. And still we require a lot of money. And at that time, we were still in the process of development of these videos, that we flew down to Chennai. And one of our initial big donors, I think he's present here, our senior from BITS Pilani, 14-year senior, Mr. MBL Bhargav. He flew down with us to make a presentation to Polaris. because he wanted to make videos, you know. And we came back with money, lots of it, rather more than what we required.
Wow.
And we set on developing those videos. It took us, I think, 2 years' time to complete videos in English and Hindi, and then other languages. And
why do you have to do it in English and Hindi? Most schools here would be only Hindi.
We are looking at India, we are looking at whole India. Yeah,
so that's why you did English as well.
Yeah. We did so other
did
languages.
Which are the softwares that you used to?
Huge number. There's a list, you know. And we took all software which were free.
Okay.
We didn't really pay software. We didn't want to pay any money unnecessarily.
And it took you 2 years to develop the entire curriculum.
Because we failed 6-7 times while developing these videos. And I think 7-8 times, we felt we are successful. No, the challenge was, we felt that we have done it. And for your information, this was the world's first computer course video which will replace a human being as claimed by us. Problem was, will it work in the field? Now, testing time came. April 2016, our videos were complete. And we talked to those 4 schools which were in our waiting list. We told them, we want to do the experiment. Will you partner with us? They said yes. So what did we do? We told them that from now on, we will not be doing the old model of computer shiksha delivery. We will be doing a new model. What is the new model? We will give you second-hand computers, refurbished from our side, with our software, whatever we want you to use, and we will teach your person, whom we will invite in our training center for 8 days, how to deliver education using these videos. And we told them, you can pick up any person who may have never ever seen a computer in life. We will train that person in 8 days' time. Not only he or she will become world-class trainer, but we guarantee that he or she will be able to repair 90% of hardware and software problems. Wow. Because by developing these manuals, we develop this manual also.
Wow.
And so 4 schools sent their representatives. We trained them.
And these computers, now there is no need to transport them. They stay with them.
Permanently with them. Because they had to put our course as part of their curriculum. So these computers have to be there in their lab. We also connected these schools with CCTV to our office. We said, we would watch.
Okay.
We told them, you are teaching using our videos, our manuals, our everything.
Our name is...
We are just watching. We are just watching to help you. And April 2016, this experiment started. 4 schools. And you'll be amazed that till August 2016, until we ran this experiment, not a single failure occurred.
Wow.
As if these 4
no
people...
No disruption.
No disruption. These 4 people have never seen a computer in life. They were considered dadas by children as well as schools as computer literacy dadas. And imagine, they had never seen a computer in life earlier.
And now see, this is the strength of your course curriculum which you prepared.
Yes.
And your training.
And our team. You have a team.
Your training. Oh,
yeah. And August 2016, we said our experiment is successful. We have developed the world's first course videos which can replace a human teacher 95%. Why? Somebody is required to run that video and stop and start, not to speak. We recommend them not to speak, but unfortunately or fortunately, they speak because they like to participate, you know. And in the surprise of these teachers who are trained by us and go back after 1 semester to 2 semesters they teach, their market value doubles.
Wow.
Because they consider themselves dada. They forget that it's our videos which is making them dada.
Which is the dada.
But anyway, it's good for them, good for school, good for us. We said, now let's grow. How do we grow? Computer teacher problem we have solved. Computers problem we have solved, which is the most expensive component in the whole offering.
Yes.
By requesting corporate to donate their end-of-life computers. And in India, every 3 to 5 years, they replace their computers.
Yes.
So we started work on that. And we tied up with many. ICICI Bank gives us 1,000 computers. And BCG gives us 500, 600 computers every year. So slowly, these contacts started getting established. And August 2016, we ended March 2017 with 5,000 students Kalinga Das. Then it became 5,000, 18,000, 36,000, and 1 lakh this year. Model is in place, scalability is in place. What do we require now? More funds and end-of-life computers. And luckily, if we have more end-of-life computers, our funds requirement is very low. We deliver the lowest cost of computer literacy in the world. No one in the world can match our cost of delivery of computer literacy course. And Government of India has recognized our work as one of the best practices to come out of India for helping poor. It's called Antodaya scheme. And we were chosen as one of the top 100 best practices to come out to help Antodaya. So this is what computer shiksha has been. And what started as a hobby has become a 24-hour job. And what was supposed to be a job has become a hobby, which is my business.
Yes, our friends in the audience are applauding you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Devdeji Maharaj, MS Ashok, they're all saying great job, CS team.
Job is not finished. I want to warn you. And we keep discussing in team. 26 crore. 1 lakh is just
yes,
a testing.
Yes, I know.
Just a testing. So we are thinking now again on the board. See, we can be 10 lakhs by March 2023, for which we have...
Tell me one thing. Sorry. Now, these 1 lakh students who are being taught at the moment, for them, how many computers are deployed?
We have deployed around 7,800 approximately computers in 540 locations in 15 states in India. And we provide 100% free lifetime maintenance warranty for these computers. We pick up these computers from all these locations through our partner DTDC ourselves if something goes wrong.
And you ship another one.
What do we do is, these teachers are trained to handle 90% of problems. So we have a CS helpline. They contact CS helpline and they show the problem on the WhatsApp video. So more than 95% gets solved between this without any physical movement of part. 5% part is required. So once we uncover, expert here certifies that this computer requires a part, we don't wait for computer to start from there.
You ship the part.
You ship the computer or a part, depending on what's needed, immediately. And we guarantee that within 3 to 5 days, it will reach there. So the classes are not disrupted. And then same DTDC picks up those computers at our cost and brings it back to our center, which gets refurbished again and goes to some
and
other.
Sent back to somebody else.
And this goes on. We have one of the best refurbishment in India now. We can compete with any corporate refurbishers. We are doing that level of job and quality. And we have a warehouse which looks like a corporate warehouse. We have 2,600 computers lying there right now. And so now we have basically captured all the processes and we have fantastic processes and very cost-efficient processes in place.
So Rakesh, this is amazing, you know, the work that you have done and how you've gone from a position of despair to this position where, you know...
Actually, I tell you that, you know, you may think I have done it, but it's not true.
Yeah, it's the team.
On the face of the organization.
Absolutely. I agree with you. I fully agree. I've seen your organization work.
Yeah. People who made the first course, people who have basically, you know, registered our organization legally. There is a company called Lochan Company, which has been with us day one. They handle our accounts.
Do your audit.
All. And see, if we don't have all this support system, then we have, you know, Bits Pilani, huge support.
The group.
We have Sofalekha Batchmat, huge support. Then we have seniors from Bits Pilani, huge support. Without all this support, you can't do anything.
You can't do anything.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
Absolutely. So I'm thankful to two things I think I learned that, which I keep repeating to myself in the years, that each and every brick, every lot of people tell me, you know, there was a lady who used to give us 1500 rupees per month in 2012.
That's also very, very, you know,
significant. She has, from May 2012, since the competition started, she has been giving us 1500 rupees from that day till today. And she told me one day that I know that this very small amount. I said, ma'am, I learned at that time that each and every brick in the building you're making is equally important. You cannot compare that somebody gave us 1 crore and you're this.
Yes,
no,
yes.
For us, you are equally important. Yeah. And second learning, which is equally important, is we think we are doing helping society is not true. We are thankful to those beneficiaries who are allowing us to help.
Give you that opportunity.
Absolutely. So we need to invert the way we are thinking. That's what is good.
See, Suri, I see this, you know, there is something called welfare,
yeah,
where people say there's social welfare. So that I consider, you know, giving clothes, giving medicine, giving food, giving shelter, all that is part of welfare.
Yeah, yeah.
But what you are doing is something which is called, you know, in Hindi we call it kalyan. Samaj kalyan ka kaam. See, this is real kalyan, where you are empowering people, where you are actually able to change their lives.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You understand? Yeah. So this is real Samaj Kalyan. Samaj Seva is one thing, but a higher form of service is Samaj Kalyan.
But there's a weakness in this. You know what the weakness is? Hmm. Our work does not evoke the same feeling of emotion in the donors. And because our work, when we first starting our work itself, is so difficult.
Intangibles are there, no?
No, see, starting our work, choosing a school to starting a school takes 6 months to 9 months time. Then teaching children takes 3 years to 5 years, and continue to teach them. Result happens much, much later.
And later on, yes, they'll remember that this was the thing.
No, beneficiaries remember, but donors, you know what they say? You know, I have had a 3 hour call from US once, and the lady told me, you know, we want to donate, and we should be able to take a photograph of the achievement within next day and give. We told her, what kind of work you want? You know, feed poor people. I mean, our work doesn't evoke that emotion.
I agree with you. And this kind of work, what you are feeding is something much more than just the human body.
I know. But share with you that what we experience a little bit from donors' perspective.
Yes. And there'll be all kinds of people who have all kinds of thoughts.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Rakesh, what I can see here is a model. And, you know, your governance part, I know, is based on tremendous values, great integrity.
Yeah.
And I know that none of you have taken a single pie from the coffers of Computer Siksha. You don't pay yourself. You never withdraw any funds for yourselves. Yeah. Everything that comes in can lie in the bank if it's not spent. Yes. It will be spent only on this. Only
on the project. On the project.
All that I know.
Yeah.
Now tell me, what is your message? There will be a lot of young people who want to get into such stuff, who want to do this. And see, a lot of NGOs got a bad name, you know, because of financial irregularities.
Yes,
and
yes.
If you tell people I'm running a very successful NGO, then sometimes people look at you with a questioning gaze. Okay, all right.
Not sometimes.
You found the easy way.
Most of the time.
Most of the time, yeah. Yeah. And they see this as, you know, finding an easy way to make money without doing much. My God, the amount of labor that you guys are doing and not getting paid for it. Mm-hmm. And I'm saying not getting paid for it in terms of monetary, you know, benefits. But what you are getting, those people cannot imagine.
one thing I'd like to add to what you're saying. We were very clear from beginning that we would like to get funding from corporate mainly, because corporate is a very tough funding. They audit you so well that we remain a straight and good NGO.
Absolutely.
And we succeeded in that. And what we did before we approached corporate is we got our NGO certified for global standards. And we worked with CAI, Credibility Assurance. They certified us. Then Benevity is the global organization who certified us. Then so we got certification from these 2-3 major global organizations. Plus, most of our donors audit us every second year. They sit at our office, check each and every bill.
But what
reports they have given to their boards are just awesome. They have one audit team, Polaris audit team, reported to the board that they have never seen an NGO like this.
Yes,
I agree. They fund huge number of NGOs. So we've been lucky Yeah, we have been lucky and we have tied up with a lot of corporate. Now what we are thinking is we want to take this 1 lakh to 10 lakh number by March 2023, and we are talking to people to support us, and you'll be happy to know that we feel that we have got most of support lined up for this. And but this is not what you want to do. This is a consequence of what's happening today will happen in 3 years' time. We want to cover 115 districts of India, which have been declared by Government of India as backward districts. We have a plan in place now for which a project report will be generated by January 2021 coming, where Alka and I, Alka will be retiring next year, and six people team will leave from Gurgaon for 8-year trip and not come back until we finish 115 districts.
Wow.
We haven't raised funds for that. We will start raising funds for this in January when we complete the report. We feel it will require around 10 to 12 crore rupees, and there's a lot of money required and a lot of support required, and that's what we are intending to do. Now, we'll have a report available for our donors and all people by January to March 2021.
Now, Suri, I've been noticing one thing, and I'm sure, you know, in India, you'll be able to scale up to that level.
Yeah.
Now, your Ghana thing has not really, what are they doing there? They have only 500 students there.
See, we learned later, we didn't know that we cannot spend any penny or effort for any foreign country. Somebody approached us from Ghana that they wanted to see what we are doing. They came over to India.
I know.
They learned our model. They replicated that model there. And can you believe that within 6 months of reaching back, they were rated as the best NGO in Ghana because they totally replicated our work.
Yeah, they replicated what you are doing.
Yeah. So we are happy and we want more countries. So there are 3-4 more countries who have shown interest in our work. And we told them everything is free, but please come here. Learn and take. Why? Because we are raising funds in India for India.
Yeah.
We are not raising
you
funds.
You can't take funds there. You can't go there and spend money.
Why should we right now? Because we have 26 crore children waiting. You see, it's a large number.
Agree.
So Ghana is on its own. They will do what they can. We are not focusing on any country.
But you give them support.
Absolutely. You see, everything
you gave them support without charging them anything. It's all free of cost. You come here and we give you support.
We can't charge. We are a NGO.
Yes, I know.
We provide all services free of cost. We don't charge anyone for it. You'll be surprised that when I visited US for raising funds, every person who was big asked me, tell me how to monetize your videos. I told them, I'm not here to monetize. Those are free. It took every... that
a lot
last
of time
person,
to understand
to convince that I'm no more money for these videos. Otherwise, I've got off. You'll be surprised. I've got an offer from a corporate in India. Huge amount. They want their name on these videos. And we told them, how can you put your name on these videos when these videos have been developed from donated funds?
Yeah, so they belong to each person who's donated.
They belong to the world.
Yes, they belong to society at large.
Yeah. Yeah, so we go through these experiences and we learn from each experience. So Ghana is independent.
There's a question that's waiting. Let me read out the question. KG Narayanan, fantastic achievement in imparting computer literacy. Good luck for future. How do you plan to ensure continuous attention to quality of delivery, objectivity in evaluation, and not be focused excessively on footfall when you are scaling up?
We think that we are the first NGO in India, if not in the world, to appoint a general manager, delivery quality, 2 months back. And what this person's job is, we have categorized all our schools in ABCD category on the basis of the interactions he has had with schools and everybody marks. So, and we, our CS interacts with school at least twice a month. Then there are physical at least once in a quarter. So all those rankings have produced a list called ABCD category. This general manager's job is to make sure that B becomes C in a given time frame, he becomes B and B becomes A. That is the only job this person has, and he is monitored monthly on this achievement.
Excellent.
I don't think any corporate also will be doing this kind of
work. Yes, I know. I know. See, if all corporates were run like your NGO.
Yeah.
And if all NGOs were run right. like a corporate the way you are doing, absolutely. Then things would get better on both the sides.
And I want to also tell you, after just of 2 months that he has joined us, and you know it's COVID time and schools are not working, you'll be surprised that two schools moved from C to B because they redesigned their labs to suit what our people were telling, even in this COVID time. So we are very confident that with this general manager quality in place, and we will keep increasing this department as the number of schools go up, we will be able to lick and not have a D or C category at all.
Yeah, I understand. And see, what you are doing is, you are doing service to the schooling system in the country.
Yes.
When a school goes up from D to C to B to A, it's not just the computer literacy department that's going up. The school is going up overall.
Yes, I agree. School is going up.
Now tell me, Suri, what did you do to counter the pandemic?
Before I come to that, shall I tell you one interesting thing more?
Sure.
Schools told us over the last 4 or 5 years that apart from delivery of computer literacy, which is a unique thing for them, and they couldn't have afforded it without help which they got, they said their number of admission seekers have gone up. The attendance has gone up, and you know, you'll be surprised, attendance on the days of computer courses there is higher.
It's more. It's all spiked.
And children do not want to take leave the day their computer period is there.
Wow.
And this has come from schools. And for us, it's a total new learning that, you know, it can happen. So it's an awesome thing. Sorry, we'll come back to your question.
Let me take one question from our audience.
Okay.
MS Ashok has asked a question. How supportive are the state governments of your efforts?
We decided long back in 2012 itself that when they were doing the NSSO 2014 analysis for us, our work, that we will not work with government initially at all. Why?
Okay.
Because we cannot give computers to government schools because we do not know who will keep them, who will be providing security. We didn't know. Okay. Then second thing, very interesting thing is there when we were doing analysis of the data, 50% of the vacancies in government schools, teacher vacancies. And out of 50% teachers who are there, we feel that they challenge in their participation in the system. So we were very clear that we will not waste a single penny for some time until we develop some solution for them. And we also found that there are 8 crore children who are studying in low budget private schools and NGO schools. So we said our universe is very large right now to experiment before we become big enough to, you know, dictate to state.
Dictate and cater to all segments.
So up to 10 lakh, we had decided not to go to any state government. But you'll be surprised that, you know, we always plan things and something else happens. That's called, it's called life. And something else happened already. You know, you have heard about BCG, Boston Consulting Group.
Yeah, of course.
They are our partner for the last 4 or 5 years. They give us 500 to 600 computers every year, and also money to repair them to do that. And BCG is a large partner for some state governments where they use their CSR fund to improve state government education. So Rajasthan state government, BCG team is working there. He came to know about computer shiksha, the BCG head of Rajasthan. He asked me that why can't we do something for Rajasthan state government. We met, we discussed, and we found that computer shiksha doesn't have the ability and wherewithal to deal with government. We don't have that kind of manpower. So BCG said, leave the problem to us. BCG will do that.
You just provide the education.
No, our role will be very simple. Our role will be provide the videos, provide the manuals, provide the training to teachers once.
Yeah, that's the education you provided everything.
And then don't interact with those teachers. Their team in head office will deal with them as per our instructions. Because we tell them, this is what you want from them, it will come.
And where do they get their computers from?
Government problem, not our problem.
Government problem. Fine. Perfect. Excellent. So you are giving them everything,
yeah.
But you are not dealing with them.
No, why? Because we are small
and cannot deal
we,
with them. Yeah.
We can't deal with them. VCD is dealing with them. And
yeah.
VCD is a large organization.
Yes.
So this experiment is going on. It started before pandemic. We trained 100 teachers from Rajasthan State Governments for 100 schools. The plan was to do 150 schools as a pilot project. And then each take 5,000 schools. This was the plan. Now the plan is obviously no more there right now. And it will come up back again only after pandemic is over.
And I remember that you had done something in the Naxal belt of Jharkhand also.
Yeah, we
tell us something about that.
Again, there is in governments also, there are some people who are very initiative taking. It's not that all government people don't work. It's not true.
No, and, they all work.
Yeah.
Some don't work.
Some don't work and they have a lot of systemic problems.
Yes, otherwise they work. The government works.
So one person from Jharkhand government, we can know, approached us and said, do something. We said, what? We're scared of governments. We can't spend single penny of donor money on government. So don't spend money. Train. We said, from where will you get computers? We will get from Delhi, local MLA to give them computers.
Fund.
So we heard all the stories, first time experience. And the education chief of that place was an awesome person. He told, come what may, I will enforce these schools to deliver your computer literacy program. Just tell me what to do. You know,
wow.
He felt so much.
That kind of commitment.
So we said, let's experiment. Our team flew down there, trained those teachers, did everything, and the classes were to start. MLA came, garlanded everybody, and announced that every school will have 15 computers within 10 days or something like that. And you know what happened? When our team came back, this education officer got transferred.
Oh.
Until today, computers have not come. And our money, which we spent to reach there and teach, it's all for the money.
Yeah, but still.
But some schools who we taught are trying to do something. They're trying to do something. Not our standard, which we force private schools to do. Something they're doing. But this is the usual problem. So state governments, we have decided to work only for the top.
Wow.
If we don't come from top, we can't handle these people shifting out and then work stopping.
Yes, agree with you.
So we will take it up in 2023 onwards. This is what our plan is. But as I told, we can plan. Things happen differently all the time.
Yeah, the universe wants something else and it's helping you.
So we'll
sari
do it.
Kainat, sari kainat lagi hui hai, computer shiksha ki madad.
That is true. That I agree with you. I agree with you.
So let me take some chat messages which are, you know, waiting for us. So Rajendra Kumar Shevde, our Maharaj ki jai ho. Maharaj says, any good deed has a cascading effect. Very nice.
Yeah.
Mohinder Bhandari says, sir, everyone works hard, but some succeed, some failed and not got what they plan to achieve. Sir, what is the missing thing between them? Okay. Missing thing batao bhai.
You're asking me or you're...
Wait, I'll repeat the question. Before that, I'll take
a I read the question.
Comment.
No.
Achha, heartening to learn about your journey. Let's think about extending your operations to Uttar Pradesh.
We are already in Uttar Pradesh.
Se baat karo, bhai.
No, we are already in Uttar Pradesh. We are Uttar Pradesh. We have a very large population in Uttar Pradesh.
Very large in Uttar Pradesh. Chalo,
yes,
great.
Very large.
Haan, toh ye question answer kar de, yaar. Mohinder Bhandari.
Which one? Okay.
In the chat.
I don't think I can answer this, but I have just a suspicion of the answer.
Sure.
I think it's just to do with perseverance, nothing else. And then whole team, you know, working together. There's nothing else which is, there's no sure short way to success, actually.
And never say die spirit.
Never say die, because we have failed so many times in the 7 years that I can't tell you. So many, I'll tell you pandemic example. Our running expense is 8 lakhs per month. If we don't do anything, we don't...
Correct.
Please, because we are maintaining these machines, we are being taking assessment exams for all the 1 lakh children. 8 lakhs is the minimum we spent every month. And when pandemic came in, so then we were very comfortable. We had corporate tie-ups in place and all. We were supposed to get 2.5 crores in April when we started. And we were surprised we got zero. All corporates told us that we have donated all the money to PM Care project. That's PM Care fund. So we told them, circus for money for us also. We need to survive. You see, if good NGOs can't survive, then what's the point?
Yeah, then what will survive?
Yeah. So I raised the panic button very soon. And then luckily, within 2-3 months, first one batchmate from US came and said, I will fund you next month, full 8 lakhs you sent. And then, you know, very interesting thing happened. And Mr. Bhargav, who is, I think, here,
yeah.
He had introduced us to a person known as Ramesh Kacholia, a great name in India. Not many people will know unless you work in NGOs. He doesn't run any NGO. But he supports huge number of NGOs.
And he looks for the best ones to fund.
No, he evaluates you for a very long time. I think he was evaluating us for maybe 1.5 years time. Despite Mr. Bhargav recommending us maybe, you know. And,
yeah, but he wants to be sure for himself.
Yeah, yeah. We couldn't have reached Mr. Kacholia if Mr. Bhargav wouldn't have given our name there. And in this pandemic, Mr. Ramesh Kacholia suddenly wakes up and says, keep working and don't bother about money. Now, somebody telling you that is a very powerful thing. And I always fall back on our old supporters, old, you know, not in age, but in the time when they're supporting us, like Mr. Bhargav and others. We always go back and say, please, sir, we don't have money right now. But now requirements have gone up. You know?
Yes.
And Mr. Kacholia...
They're significant now. The requirements significant. Are significant. Now.
Yeah. So Mr. Kacholia told me, calculate from today to 31st March, how much money you need. So I calculated, I said, we had received Yahoo funding. Luckily, that didn't cancel. That was previous funding. And we also got Deloitte funding, little bit, small amounts. So I said, gap is only 60 lakhs. He says, okay, from now onwards, remember, I will be at least helping you arrange 50% of your funding every year. Wow. So 50% of funding, balance 50%, you arrange yourself. And very interestingly, within 1 month, he had arranged 50% funding. And he asked me, where is your part of funding? I said, I will take you 31st March, is it? 30 lakhs would arrange it at 10. But he said, what Mr. Bhargav says, I will say, focus on 10 lakh number.
Yes.
Deliver this number to us.
Reach that figure. Come on.
Deliver this number to us by March 2023. Don't bother over money. We will help you find it. So that's our first and main target right now. And this BCG kind of experiment we will do as a proper thing. But through
BCG, this may become a pilot. The BCG might become a pilot.
Yes.
Suri?
Yeah.
You and your team, I don't know, you know, you've been recognized by newspapers, you've been recognized by bodies as a significant person and all that. When will our government take note of this?
Government has already taken.
They should give you the Padma Vibhushan and all that. Awards may come.
I'm not, as well. Not interested.
You are not clamoring for them, I know.
Not
then they need to take note of all this.
If you ask me, you know, when we should all, our whole team should get whatever award should happen.
Agreed.
At least reach 50% of 26 crores. But that won't happen in our lifetime. I'm not sure, but we want to do it before that. You know?
Yeah, see, Suri, there are many people who leave a legacy.
Yeah.
And those who leave a legacy are true legends. But you, my friend, you've created a legacy during your lifetime.
You're already
a legend.
I thank you so much.
Understand, you're already a legend, my friend.
I'm the face of the legend.
I agree with you. But there is always somebody who's required to be the captain of a ship.
Yeah.
Who guides the ship.
Yeah.
You know, who founds the principles on which things are going to run.
Yeah.
Because people may fail, systems will succeed.
Yeah.
So, you know, things that you won't do are more important than things that you would do.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is what we need to understand. So, brother, now tell me a little more about what your kids are doing. Alka, of course, is a very, very senior government scientist.
Yeah. When I started NGO and when we decided that I will do this full time and I will spend very little time on the investments I had in corporate world, I took permission of my children.
Wow.
Because I won't be CEO anymore. No, you can't have a foreign trip if you want, or you can't have that kind of money which I was earning. So it naturally brings a constraint or the way you are supposed to live. And Alka and my children all said, you please go ahead. Do what you want.
And they must be so proud of what you're doing.
Absolutely. You see, without family support, you can't do this.
Nothing can happen.
Yeah. So both children are doing well. Isha is a product manager in Comviva after doing B.Tech engineering and master's from Carlson Business School US.
So they're both engineers?
Isha is an engineer at MBA. And Prakram is B.Tech and he's undergoing MS from Austin University.
Very nice.
He's working in Cognizant. So he's studying along with the work.
Great.
Yeah, so they are on their own careers, lives.
So tell me, Suri, you've been involved with computer Shiksha now for about 8 years. Yeah. And today, what would your typical day look like?
Both Alka and I get up at 4:30 a.m. in the morning. And we do yoga and all that. And
what time do you sleep?
We sleep by 9:30 to 10, between 9:30 to 10.
So I'm already approaching your bedtime.
Today it's okay. You're talking
all right. Today.
And out of working hours, I spend around at least 12 hours on computer Shiksha. Because it has become big now. There is a saying in computer Shiksha that we don't sleep. Means you send us an email or a WhatsApp message within few
somebody
hours.
Somebody will reply.
Somebody. And each of our employees from last 3-4 years is in habit of carrying a laptop and being in holiday leave wherever they are supposed to respond. And that's so they have learned all that. They have become like corporate people.
What you've done is you've taken empowerment across all levels in the organization.
Yes. Small
to help somebody. They don't need to ask somebody, should I help? Should I send? Whosoever sees that somebody requires help, helps, and it's done.
And they're young people and they're working very hard.
Excellent.
I tell them there's no office hours. 24 hours is the office hours.
Yeah. Yeah, you're always on duty.
But our helpline does work. Yeah, limited time.
How do you relax?
Oh, I relax by thinking how to increase the numbers.
My God. So tension is relaxation for you.
There's not tension.
There's no tension. Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, this is.
In the corporate, it was always a tense world. How to improve stakeholder value quarter after quarter. Here, it's a passion.
Yeah,
see, that tension a passion. Yeah. You need to add more kids.
Yeah, each
and
child
impact new lives.
Yeah. Each child, imagine you reach.
Absolutely. See, I can understand, I can imagine the joy that you feel.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
The joy that you would be feeling. Now, my young colleague Sonia Jetley is here with us and she also says it's very, very informative.
Thank you, Sonia.
Yeah. So, buddy, now, as we come, okay, already 17 minutes past 9. Wow. Wow, that's great. See, I have so many more questions.
Okay.
Now tell me, if somebody else wants to start an NGO, maybe in any area, what are the founding principles that they must keep in mind?
First and most important, you should not be ashamed of not having money.
Okay.
Yourself. Because if you want to start, let's say you are a fresher and you want to start something like an NGO and you may withdraw salary from NGO, it's nothing bad or wrong in it. We have taken this not to withdraw, but it doesn't mean you should not. You should withdraw salary. But remember, you will never be able to compete with your compatriots who will be working in corporate. And tomorrow, that's after 5-7 years you meet and you see that person coming in a big car and you might be driving a small market of a kind, you should not feel ashamed. If you can conquer that feeling, cost problem solved.
Enter the world.
Second is that the pleasure which you will get, that can never happen in corporate. Never, never. And that, I'm not saying you should enter when you're fresher. You go to corporate, earn money, learn there. You try to do it after 10, 15 years of experience. You will bring more value to the NGO. But it doesn't mean the freshers have not started NGO, because a lot of freshers I see who have started NGO, they're doing wonderful jobs.
And doing very well.
Very well, very well. So there's nothing, no fixed model. My suggestion is work 10, 15 years, then come. But as I said, freshers have done it.
So anybody with a passion and probably who has this kind of a mindset would be able to do it happily and remain happy.
Yeah, remain happy. Happiness remain is guaranteed. Happy. One thing I tell you, happiness is guaranteed. You will not be, you will not have stress. You will not have BP. You will be extremely happy. You will sleep very well. And you will look forward to the next day.
Wow.
Fantastic.
Great. Excellent. Now, buddy, tell me, have you ever thought about writing a book or have you already
We are working on ended? It. We are. We want to pen down each and every learning that comes to Shiksha so that somebody...
Not only that, maybe, your journey.
It's a part of that. It's together.
Your
it's
thoughts, a, your ideas.
It's a mixed thing and Swapan Lekha has done work on it and she's working continuously on it.
Because see, they made a movie on Super 30.
I know.
So Super we are Shiksha right hai yaar ye. This is a story that needs to be told.
We are on the job. We are writing for ourselves right now. We haven't talked to anybody till now and neither somebody has approached us. We are writing about it right now.
For what? Approached you for what?
Nobody is supposed to write our story yet. So, but we are writing ourselves right now. We are penning down everything, what we are learning, what's happening, what events are there, what anecdotes are there. We are writing down everything.
This needs to be told.
Absolutely.
Book my copy now. Great.
Thank you.
Now, if there is one message that you would like to give to our youth who are waiting to enter the corporate, who are waiting to start their lives, what would that message be? It can be a slightly longer message.
Try to not look for only money.
Wow.
Try to look for, you know, being happy. Because we, as we see society today, people not happy, unfortunately. Many people, most people, I will say. They are fighting that rat race. You know, bigger house, bigger car, bigger bank balance. After some time, you keep one thing in mind. God forbid, when let's say when your last day on this planet comes and you are thinking about your life, would it matter to you that how much money you had in the bank or how many houses you built or how many cars you drove? What will you remember that time? What you did?
What you did and what you felt.
What good you did and what wrong you did. And you better have more good than
positive balance.
Unfortunately, why learn that time only? Learn right now.
Yes.
And live your life that way.
Live a meaningful life.
Yeah, live a meaningful life. A happy life.
Excellent. I always say this, Suri, to my students also.
Mm.
Agar aap khush nahi hai,
तो
आप कुछ नहीं
है कुछ नहीं
है यू आर नॉट हैप्पी यू आर नथिंग बिकॉज दैट आई थिंक इज द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट कंडीशन
एंड रैट रेस इज टू बी अवॉइडेड समहाउ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू इंप्लीमेंट इजी टू से
वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू इंप्लीमेंट
या
सो एज वी कम टूवर्ड्स द क्लोजिंग part of this, if there are any other questions, there are no other questions. My friend Ashok has said, Dr. Suri, appreciate and salute your dedication and passion. Was a pleasure hearing you and about your work.
Thank you, Ashok. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Ashok. Thanks, buddy. So, my dear friend, Surius, as we call you. Surius is always smiling. Yes, you are a brilliant person. So Surius, legend in your own lifetime. My good friend, we all love you from the core of our hearts. And we really admire what you are doing. And I wish, you know, had I been living in Gurgaon where I used to be before 2008, I would have really helped you out on the ground, you know. I would have loved to be there and teach these kids and, you know, help out. But we'll see how we can find some way to work together. And it's been a wonderful, wonderful evening, full of life, full of learning, full of love, full of passion. And it's rare to find people like you, and may your drive increase. And I, on behalf of the audience also, would like to really thank you And yeah, there is a message. There is a message. Very, very interesting. Nagendran, very, very interesting experience shared. Superb work done. Please carry on. MK Jain, our friend. Our friend, model.
Model. Oh, model. The supporter of computer.
Very much. All the best to CS. Yes, model. Mm-hmm. All the best to you also.
He's a partner of computer Shiksha.
Yes, yes. Model is a partner everywhere.
Yes. Everywhere, yes.
Yes. Mukut Bihari also.
Oh, our senior, 14 years senior. 14 years senior.
Very, very happy to see this and hear you.
Mr. Mukut Bihari Lal is 14 years senior from Bits Pilani.
Wow. So I would like to, you know, thank you once again, my friend. And this is just a beginning. I would be inviting you for more such talks to our students and interactions.
Would love to
and
do that.
I wish you the very best to you, you know, for everything that you are doing, and more power to you. The universe is watching, and I'm sure, you know, whenever you have these milestones, then I'll get to know about them. Then we'll celebrate here on the show.
Yes, we'll do that.
And your 10 lakh, 1 million celebration will be a huge, huge celebration that we'll do on the show.
Absolutely.
And maybe we'll do a live, celebration, and we'll telecast, webcast this live
from the school. From the school, where we'll have 1 million.
Yes, we'll do that. I'll come there and we'll do that, my dear friend. Yeah. So, Rakesh, thank you so much, and please give my love to both the kids, and my very warm regards to Alka, and my love to you, my friend.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much, buddy. You take care. God bless you, and see you again. So, viewers, as we come to the end of another episode of That's Life, I promise you next week we'll meet again, and we'll meet with another guest, another Sunday, another episode of That's Life. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Thank you.